Okay, so I would say here that in the proof, of the pasting above pasting lemma, the step where we take unions of closed sets may not work, for infinite unions. Hence, the pasting lemma doesn't hold for infinite unions. Yani aslında main at diyeyim de şöyle. Infinite unions. Indeed, I will ask you a question. Maybe it is already in the list. Where, on that example, a function is continuous on each closed subset, but the function is not continuous on the union because of that, reason. So, okay. What else? Okay, there is this product spaces maps into products. Let me also state that maps into products. But this is only product of finite many spaces. if okay, let F be a map from A into the product X and Y of X and Y be given by the formula, by the equation. So F of A is equal to F1A, F2A for some functions, F1 from A to X and F2 from A to Y. Then the conclusion is this, then F is continuous if and only if each Fi is continuous. Okay. And let's see the proof. So, let's take an open subset in the product. Or maybe, okay, yeah. Consider the projection maps. Pi1 from X cross Y into X and Pi2 from X cross Y into Y given by pi 1 x comma y is equal to X and pi to x comma y is equal to y for all x, y in x. Okay. Well, these are continuous maps. Note that if u is in x, an open subset is open, then what is the inverse image of u? So what are the elements sent into u under this function? Well, x has to be in u, of course. What about y? Y can be anything. Therefore, this is nothing but x cross y, sorry, u cross y, which is open, which is open, right? Because x is open, y is open, therefore the product is open. Hence, y1 is continuous. Well, similarly, of course, pi 2 is continuous. Similarly, maybe I told this already, but I am not sure, is also continuous. And we have what now? Okay. Also note that. Note that F1 A is equal to what? This is just the okay. Also note that since F of A is what? This is F1 A, F2 A, and thus F1 A is equal to just the first component of this, so it is just pi 1 of f of a, and f2 a is just pi 2 of f of a, for all a in a. Thus, F1 is just the composition, pi 1 composition F, and F2 is the composition, pi 2 composition F. So, if F is continuous, then since pi 1 and pi 2 are continuous, right? F1 and F2 are continuous because they are compositions of two continuous functions since they are compositions of okay of sorry continuous functions. Okay. For the converse direction, for the converse statement, let F1 and F2 be continuous. Okay. Then we would like to show that F is continuous. So, how can we check whether F is continuous? Well, F is a function from A into the product x comma y. So let me take a open set here. actually a you know basis element for this open set is just U cross V, right? So let's take an open set like this. Consider yani inverse image'i open set'in inverse image'lerine bakmak yerine basis elemanların da inverse image'lerine baksam yeterli. Consider a basis element U cross V where U is open and are open. Okay. Well, then what is the inverse image of U cross V? Well, this is the same thing as saying A is in A such that F of A, which is what? F1A, comma F2A is in U cross V, right? Well, this means what? This is the same thing as F1A is in U and F2A is in V. But what is this? This is just F inverse of A, no, F inverse of U, F1 inverse of U. İsterseniz şöyle yazayım. This is F1 is in U, intersection A is in A, F2A is in V. But what is this? This is nothing but F1 inverse of U. And this is F2 inverse of U. Well, F1 and F2 are continuous. Therefore, these preimages are open. And this is a finite intersection of open sets. Therefore, it is open. Okay. Since both F1 and F2 are continuous. We see that F U cross V, F inverse U cross V is open. Because this is open, this is open, and this is a finite intersection, therefore that's also open. And this finishes the proof, right? Okay. Here again, I make the following remark. You know, this product, this proof doesn't work for infinite products. Because since intersection of intersection of infinitely many open subsets may not be open. Well, you may say that we haven't seen any actually infinite products, right, so far. Well, that's the next topic, actually. So we will see it soon. Yeah, Arsh, okay. Arsh, okay. basis elements, therefore they are also open, right? And here I just check whether this is open or not, only for basis elements, but we know that any set is a union of basis elements. Therefore, you know, if I take arbitrary open set, it would be union of such, you know, U and V's. Therefore, it wouldn't be, you know, problem. Onu gösterdik mi? Did we show that, you know, we can check continuity using only the basis elements? I don't remember. We define it, you know, using open sets, but actually it is enough to check only for a basis, you know, for a basis, right? Just open sets contained in a basis would be enough. Yeah, the okay, yeah, it follows from that also. Yeah, you're right. Well, yeah, the same idea. It's not exactly that, but the same idea. So the thing is the following. So maybe I write as a remark also. Okay, let F from X to Y be any map. And a basis for the topology on Y. Okay. Then F is continuous. Continuous. If and only if. Only if. F inverse of B is open in X for all B in B. Okay. Why is that? Proof is very easy. Well, if F is continuous, if F is continuous, then F inverse of B is open. Because B is a basis element, it's an open subset. It's open since it belongs to a basis. Okay. For the other direction, okay, now for the other direction, assume that F inverse of B is open for all B in B, then for any open subset, subset U of Y, we have what? U is equal to the following. It is a union of basis elements. So it is just the union of B's such that B is contained in U, right? Just take the basis elements contained in U, then U is the union of those. Hence, what is the inverse image of U? Well, this is the inverse image of this union. So, of course, these are basis elements, right? Which are contained in U, but this is nothing but in union of inverse images of B's. B is an open set contained in U, basis element contained in U. And this is nothing but Which is a union of open sets in X, hence F inverse of U is open. Okay. Yeah, I don't remember we discussed this before, but yeah, this is what I've used above. Okay. Well, here comes the product topology. Any questions so far? Any other questions? Okay. Let's talk about the product topology. We already mentioned product topology, but we discussed this only for product of two spaces, right? Now we already okay studied the product X cross Y for two spaces. Okay. But product of even three spaces is kind of problematic. Why is that? You see, if you have three spaces X, Y, Z, then you can take product of this like this, product of these two, and then take the product with Z, or you can do this thing. Okay. Product of Y and Z, and then take the product with X. All these things are slightly different, but we will see that actually we can define product more generally, and in that case things are actually more straightforward. So let's see how I do this, how it is done. Okay. In this section, we will consider arbitrary products. Okay, so let's start with the definition. Let J be an index set. It can be any set, okay? Given a set X, header set, we define a J tuple of elements of X to be a function X from J into X. Okay. If alpha is an element of J, then we often denote the value X of alpha by X alpha, okay, rather than X of alpha. Okay, and called the alphabet coordinate of X. Okay. Moreover, I will explain all this. Moreover, we denote the function X itself by the symbol. Şöyle göstereceğiz. Yani x c'den x'e bir fonksiyon aslında ama daha çok biz onu şöyle yapacağız. Göstereceğiz. X alfalar. Alfa is in c. Okay, let's see. Why we introduce such a gadget. Let's see examples. Let's, for example, take J to be 1, 2, 3, just 3 elements. O zaman şey neymiş? J tuple dediğimiz bir x'in içinde. So a J tuple in a set X is a function X from J into X. Yani bunlar da nedir? Şimdi 3 tane. So J has already 3 elements, right? Only 3 elements. So to define a function, I have to just specify the values of this function at these 3 points. So they are x of 1, x of 2, and x of 3. But instead of this notation, right, we will write like this: x1, x2, and x3. So a J tuple actually, right, I can represent this function like this. For example, just 3 elements. But I will usually represented like this. This is something we are familiar, right? So three tuples in X, right? Three tuples in X ya da triples in X. Another example, if you choose, for example, J to be n, so 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. So then a J tuple in a set X is what? Is a sequence, right? Is a function X from N into X. Which is just a sequence in X, right? X is a function from integers into X. So X is specified by its values at 0, at 1, at 2, and so on, right? At n. But we usually denote this by x0, and then this is x1, x2, xn. And what is this? This is just a sequence. And we actually write this as xn, right? N in n. A sequence is a function from n to x. So what I am defining is just a generalization of our actually Cartesian products. Triples, doubles, or n-tuples, or sequences. Another example is something again we are familiar. Let J to be the set of real numbers. Okay. Then a J tuple in, let's say, X, Let me choose x to be also r, not just an arbitrary set, but r is a function x from where to where? From j to x, which is r to r. So a j tuple is nothing but a function, okay? And if I use this notation, so I will represent this function as how x of actually, let's say this function is this x of t, okay? So I will represent this as like this, x sub t, t is in r. This is not actually something we use to represent a function from r to r, but you know, we have this notation. Okay, so why this is actually good? It is because of the following definition. This is a very nice way of representing Cartesian products. So let a alpha in this index set be an indexed family of sets. Okay, family of sets. And let X to be the union of these subsets, this set, sorry. So I have a family of sets and I have taken their union. The Cartesian product of this indexed set, indexed family sets denoted by, şöyle göstereceğiz, Cartesian product'ı, x alfaların product'ı, not x, sorry, a alfaların product'ı, alfa is in j, is defined to be the set of all functions of all j tuples. J tuple'lar neydi? Fonksiyonlar. J'den X'e giden fonksiyonlar. Of elements of x such that each x alpha is in a alpha for any alpha in j. Yani o zaman şöyle, in other words, bu nesne şu. Neymiş bunlar? Fonksiyonlar. Nereden? J'den. Union of A alfalara. Öyle ki her bir C için bunun görüntüsü şeyin içinde olacak. Pardon, her bir alfa için, alfa C'nin içinde olduğuna göre görüntüsü de yani şunları alacağız. X alfa E alfanın içinde kalacak. Okay. Tabii biz bunu nasıl yazıyoruz? Biz şöyle yazıyoruz. X alfa izin A alfa. Yani bu da şu demek aslında. Let me make an example. Let's consider x1, x2, x3. Cartesian product of three sets. What would be the elements of this? It would be just, A1, A2, A3, right? Where AI is in big is in XI, right? I from 1, 2, 3. So here this is actually just can be thought as like this. I is in J. And what is J? J is this set. 1, 2, 3, right? So actually this is nothing but a function from J into union of x1, x2, x3 in this union so that A1, which is A of 1, is in x1, A2, which is A of 2, is in x2, and A3, which is A3, is in x3. So this notation is nothing but a convenient way of representing products of families of sets. For finite products like this one, actually we don't need such a notation. But for infinite products, this is the best actually formulation, okay, to represent infinite products, Cartesian products. Okay. You see here, for example, this even get rid of difficulty of putting parentheses. One can define Cartesian product of two sets, but what about Cartesian product of three sets? Okay, there are several options. You may take Cartesian product of these two and then take Cartesian product with this one. Or you can do this. And then here comes the question. How are they related? Are they the same thing? Well, they are not the same thing, right? Because this is a tuple. And then you have this object. And here you have, okay, this thing. And they are not the same. What about this thing? I can represent this what? Yeah, I mean like this, but again I have to kind of relate all these gadgets with each other. The above formulation, get rid of all these complications. We define Cartesian products as a set of functions, okay, defined from the index set into the union of all these sets, okay. And here the order of the sets is not important, right? Because this is just a union. So it has, this advantages. Okay, so what about topology on those products? Okay, let me say product topology. Now let X alpha alpha is in J, be an indexed family of topological spaces. Now I have sets, but each one is indeed a topological space, so it has a topology. I may have finite collection like this or infinite collection or family. Then consider the product set. So I consider this one. Okay. Well, what is this gadget? This is just, of course, okay, let me write here, x alphas, what is this? This is the set of all x's, right, functions from J into union of x alphas such that x of J is in, no, x of alpha is in alpha for all alpha in J. Or put differently, this is nothing but x alphas, right? Ya da tamam kalsın. Ama öyle de yazabilirim. Şöyle yazayım. Okay. X alphas. Alpha is in J. Such that X alpha is in X alpha. Okay. I have this Cartesian product. Elements is regarded as functions on the index set. From the index set into the union. But at each alpha, the value of x lies in x alpha. Okay. There are several ways of defining topology on this product. We will describe a couple of them. The most important one is the product topology. And there is also box topology, but it turns out that box topology is something very strong, just too strong. Let me introduce those topologies. One may define several topologies on the product set, right? This is just a product set. One of them is so-called, which hello. Ya da şöyle diyeyim. Sum of which will be described okay. So one of them is box topology. Okay. Okay. I will tell you actually a basis for this. Consider the collection collection of subsets. Subsets. Şöyle subsetlere bakalım. U alfaların product'ı alfa izin J olmak üzere where each U alfa in X alfa is open. So I take open subsets of X alphas and then take their products, okay? This collection is a basis for a topology called the box topology on the product. Okay. Why box topology? Because you consider it this way. So let's say, you know, this is X alpha, this is X beta, two of these spaces, and U alpha is something like this. It's an open set. Here, U beta is something like this, and I consider their product. So we have, you know, something like this as the product, a box. That's the reason this is called box topology. Of course, one has to check that this is a basis for a topology. And let's do that in the third hour. Let me stop here.